Hello. We're going to talk about education and the passion for educating children with Dr. Joyce Roberts today on The Bernie Hayes Show. Dr. Joyce Roberts is my guest. Dr. Roberts, welcome to the show. How are you?
Good morning, Bernie. I'm so happy to see you.
I'm so happy to see you, too. I'm so happy that you came out. Even during this pandemic, you still took time to come and visit with us here at the New Life Evangelist Center. Thank you.
You're absolutely welcome.
Dr. Roberts, I've known you for so long, and since I've known you, your passion has been to educate the children. Tell us a little about that, where you get that desire, that passion from?
Well, Bernie, it's a story that many of us have. I started playing school very early and decided then that I wanted to be a teacher. And so I went to Harris Teachers College. And from there, at that time, Harris served as a pipeline to St. Louis Public Schools. And so upon graduation, I was given my first assignment at Pierre Laclede Elementary School as an elementary school teacher. And so as time went by, I was fortunate enough to come back to the place where I started, Pierre Laclede Elementary School, as the building principal, surrounded by an amazing staff and wonderful families. We worked together and we were able to be recognized as a Gold Star Blue Ribbon school. And from there, I went to central office where I served in a variety of positions. I served as executive director of middle school education, went on to become the assistant superintendent for low performing schools, and also served as the assistant superintendent for professional development before transitioning to the first state takeover, which was the Wellston School District. And from there, I also provided some services to the Normandy School District, as well as the women of AKA Sorority, who were then in charge of Ethel Hedgman Lau Charter School. Right. And so I've had an amazing career, amazing opportunities, and I'm still in service of kids. I'm doing what I was built to do. My steps have been blessed and guided.
And you're now the president of the St. Louis School Board, is that correct?
Yes, sir. I was nominated and voted into that position in April, and now I do provide leadership with an amazing team of board members dedicated to ensuring that our kids get a world-class education.
You didn't mention Williams School.
Williams Middle. How could I forget Williams Middle
know.
School? Of course. I served as the writing enrichment teacher at Williams Middle, the instructional coordinator at Williams Middle, went on to become the assistant principal and also principal of Williams Middle School.
Right.
And at that time, our emphasis was aviation and aerospace. We joined in partnership with McDonnell Douglas at the time and were able to provide our children some amazing opportunities outside of the classroom. One event in particular was a trip to the Johnson Space Center, where our children were able to actually step foot inside of Mission Control. And we were able, the boys and girls were able to come back and assimilate a mission launch of their own. So our kids are capable of everything. It's our responsibility to ensure that they are exposed and challenged.
Yeah, because I remember some of the, when you were in Williams Middle, that the kids, some of them were aspirants to become astronauts themselves.
Absolutely.
Yeah, they wanted to fly in space, go into space and become an astronaut and the support personnel. It's so much that you've done.
Sometimes I forget, Bernie. Thank you for reminding me.
Of course. The elected school board is now you're the president of, but then there also was the appointed school board. And what did you do during that time?
I'm sorry, Bernie, would you...
During the time that there was the appointed school board, you weren't with the elected school board at that time. What was your position then, and what did you think about the appointed board?
Well, when the special administrative board came on, I was at home. Mm-hmm. I had really transitioned out of the day-to-day operations of schools. And so the special administrative board came in because the state declared the district insolvent financially and academically. And so their role was somewhat different than the elected school board role in terms of following the guidelines set forth by the state.
Mm-hmm. Now, what's the mission of your position now, the elected board? Your mission. What's the mission of the elected board?
Our mission for the elected board is aligned with the vision that the community has set forth for us. It's in line with the values they have set forth. They want a high quality education for all students. They want transparency. They want to be included in the decision making. And those are all of the things that I ran on as a candidate.
Mm-hmm. And how close do you work with DESE, the Department of Education and Secondary Education?
Well, we work very closely with DESE. We're mandated, of course, by the state for certain outcomes.
Mm-hmm.
But we do work very closely with not only DESE, but the Missouri School Board Association as well. We want to be in compliance. And we also want to make sure that as board members, we are adequately prepared for the tremendous job that's before us. And so we spend quite a bit of time engaging in professional development that's provided by the Missouri School Board Association.
How important is it to you that the African-American child or child's minority children get the same education that some of the other districts provide?
It's a top priority for me. When I look at my young people, I see myself. And so it's incumbent upon not only the school board, but families, community, businesses, all of us to lean in to ensure that we're providing all of the opportunities that our young people need in terms of serving as role models, making sure that we're encouraging them, making sure that we're providing opportunities for them to connect with business opportunities across the St. Louis area, and that may be as interns. And so it's a whole community effort.
Mm-hmm. The St. Louis Public Schools, now the different divisions, right? You still have charter schools and other schools. I don't know, I can't recall the names of them now. But
they're private,
so
and parochial,
right?
They're charter and
yeah.
They're public schools.
Mm-hmm.
And there's still all of our kids, and our board has decided to ask the community to stand with us to support a moratorium that we have put forth so that we can all as a community engage in conversations and strategies to ensure that no matter where kids attend schools, that they're getting a quality education. And that can only happen, I believe,
mm-hmm.
if we pause. And our parents help us with the moratorium as well so that we can find out how we can work together for the benefit of kids.
Do you still have magnet schools?
We still have magnet schools.
What is a magnet school?
A magnet school has a particular focus. It's specialized. And we've become a district of choice. And by that I mean our families move all across the city. And that has created what we call our neighborhood schools are challenged because parents have the right to select where their kids go to school.
Mm-hmm.
So we've become a district of choice.
I remember at one time, the previous administration, two or three previous administrations were gung-ho for charter schools. How do you feel about charter schools?
I am accepting of charter schools because, mm-hmm. as I've said, we are a community of choice, and our parents have decided that they want to try charter schools. I just encourage them to make sure that they understand what that choice does overall and that they hold charter schools to the same expectations and standards that they expect from public education, and understand, too, that some of the guidelines that St. Louis Public School must follow are not the same guidelines that are in place for charter schools. And so when someone comes to your door knocking and say, come on over to our school, make sure you do your homework and understand what that choice absolutely means.
Okay. Dr. Joyce Roberts, president of the St. Louis Board of Education, St. Louis School Board, is our guest today. And we'll be right back with her after these messages.
Have you discovered the benefits of giving? If you receive God's gift of eternal life through the giving of His Son, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, as John 3:16 says, that whoever believeth in Him shall not perish but everlasting life, you will then discover the joy from giving to others. Freely we have received the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Once we've experienced Him and His reality as a part of our life, we're going to want to freely give to others that are in need. That's why Jesus said in Matthew 25, when I was hungry, did you feed me? Naked, did you clothe me? Sick or in prison, you visit me? A stranger, did you welcome me? He said, as oft you've done to the least of these, even so, you've done it to me. So first, receive God's free gift of eternal life. It's a free gift, for by grace are you saved, that not of yourself, it's a gift of God. And then freely give, for it's truly more blessed to give than to receive, and He gives us so many opportunities to help on a daily basis. Let's let our light shine, and let's freely give as God has given unto us.
Welcome back. My guest is Dr. Joyce Roberts, president of the St. Louis School Board. Dr. Roberts, the understanding is that you made a deal with the Local 420 of the St. Louis Union. Tell us about that, please.
Oh, I'd be happy to. We were at the end of a three-year agreement with Local 420, and I'm happy to say that the negotiations went well. We we're excited about our teachers who show up every day, work very hard in classrooms along with the support personnel, and we were happy to reach an agreement that was satisfactory for the membership. And Mr. Cummings and I were able to sign that agreement earlier this week.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, as I introduced you at the beginning of the program, your passion is for educating children. What's the importance of starting at the roots, at the beginning, at kindergarten, and following through K-12? Well, what's the importance to you?
Well, it's important because without our young people, the community does not thrive. And so I want to encourage everyone to understand that we are all teachers. We are teachers in the home. You may not be certified, and that's okay. But the preparation for our young people's success begins at home with their first teachers. And so we want to support and encourage our families. I'm in touch with a group called Parents Surviving the Pandemic. And so everyone really had to course correct to ensure that while instruction was interrupted at the building level, that we did indeed continue that at home. And so our kids are our community, they're our future, they're our replacements, and we want them to be well prepared to take over that leadership role. And so much so that I just think we're building leaders. We start with junior leaders. Those are our young people that we see at home and in schools, and we build their capacity so that they can take over leadership roles all across this planet.
Wonderful. How closely do you work with the superintendent, Kelvin Adams?
I work very closely with the superintendent. In fact, the entire board does. He is our only employee. And so we work very closely and directly with him in terms of setting the tone and expectations for the instructional delivery to our young people.
Now, St. Louis School Board have outreach programs. Do they not? Tell us some about them.
Well, the outreach programs are one that I would like to highlight is we're starting it. I want to encourage any person who's excited about running to become a member of the St. Louis Board of Education that you do your homework. It's not a position where you come and you just do things. You're working with a group of seven, and it's important to educate yourself around the goals of the board. And currently, our board goals are aligned with the district goals. Our focus is on reading, math, and college and career readiness. Some other outreach programs, we have a PAC, Parent Action Committee, that I want to encourage every parent to become a part of. And if you cannot do it directly, there are other ways that you can support their work. You can also join the parent organization at your local school. You're more than welcome to be a part of that and to be a part of the decision-making at the local level. But please don't abdicate your responsibility and role as being partners with the school district and with the school board.
Mm. Are school board meetings open to the public, and when are they held?
Our meetings are open to the public. We have had to course correct during the pandemic, and we began Zooming or Facebook Live. I'm happy to say that we are going back to limited in-person attendance.
Oh, wonderful. And where are the school board meetings held? And can one come and voice their opinions?
The school board meeting will be held at our central office located at 801 North 11th Street in room 108. As I said, we are returning to in-person attendance. It will be on a first-come, first-served basis. We will follow social distancing and masking, and you will sign up in order to speak.
Mm-hmm. I know there are a lot of schools closing too, but I assume that's a budgetary problem. Is that correct?
We had to make a very hard decision to close some of our schools. Mm-hmm. There are a variety of reasons why that happened. Budget constraints, attendance in at the building level were, of course, factored in along with some other data that we were provided.
Dr. Roberts, every time I see you, I know you oftentimes you're very prayerful. Tell us about your faith, because I know you, it's deep, it runs deep. Tell me about it.
Well, Bernie, I am deeply rooted in my faith. It has gotten me through some highs and some very lows. I would not be present had I not been gifted to do the work that I'm doing. Hard decisions are anchored around prayer. It's also anchored in what I would do for my own children. The students in St. Louis Public Schools, I believe, are mine, and I'm going to make the best decision that I can for them. All of my decisions are rooted in data, and I'm very comfortable on having an opinion, and I give all praise and honor to the power greater than myself that continues to bless and guide this world. Mm-hmm.
Do you visit the schools themselves, some of the schools in the district?
Oh, absolutely. Mm-hmm. That was a must for me. I've been in every school in the district in my time on the board. I did all of that in my first year. I continue to visit schools and classrooms. In fact, I came to the Blues Museum on the day of the field trip. And so it's important that school feeds is the energy I need to get this work done. Mm.
Well, I can say, tell the world that Dr. Joyce Roberts has been a great supporter of mine. And you visited the National Blues Museum recently. You've been a very staunch supporter of us at the Aristotle State University, the wing playing, and the Wolf Jazz Institute, and the National Black Radio Hall of Fame. And I just want to say thank you, because I know how active you are in the community and how much you love the community and how much you do for the community. And I just want people to know who Dr. Joyce Roberts is. And I just want to say thank you so much for all that you do, because I know you won't stop doing it.
Bernie, it's reciprocal. You are a staunch supporter of the community as well. I also know and believe that support matters, and we have to show up and support one another, just as you've done. I know that you sit on the board of the at Sumner, along with the Shakespeare and the Bill, and so you continue to support education, and I'm very grateful for that.
Thank you.
On behalf of St. Louis Public Schools and the young people we serve.
You're very kind, Dr. Roberts. We got to take another short break here. But I want to come back and ask you some more questions. And just thank you again for being with us. We'll be right back after this.
So many people are being left on the streets homeless all day long without anywhere to go because downtown St. Louis continues to fight efforts to reopen 1411 Locust. Yes, the downtown neighborhood organization that has continued to fight the New Life Evangelistic Center for the reopening of 1411 Locust and lobbied the Slay administration, the Cruzison administration, to keep it closed and close it down, must be strongly resisted at this particular time. We have a new mayor. I believe she cares about the homeless. Tashara Jones needs our support. And if downtown St. Louis is going to resist her efforts to reopen 1411 Locust, then we have to call for a boycott of downtown St. Louis. And that's why I'm asking the Burning Hayes viewers to please consider doing such. If you'll join me in prayer over this, if you'll join me in resisting these special interest groups, if you want to believe the time for action is now, please contact me. I'm Larry Rice at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, 63166. You can call me at 314-421-3020. I thank God for faithful viewers of Bernie Hayes, and now the time for action has come.
Today's Black History subject are the Tuskegee Airmen, a group of African-American and Caribbean-born military pilots who fought in World War II. They formed the 332nd Fighter Group and the 477th Bombardment Group of the United States Army Air Force. The name also applies to navigators, bombardiers, mechanics, instructors, crew chiefs, nurses, cooks, and other support personnel. All black military pilots were educated at Tuskegee University, formerly Tuskegee Institute, located near Tuskegee, Alabama. The group included five Haitians and from the Haitian Air Force and one pilot from Trinidad. It also included Hispanic or Latino airmen born in the Dominican Republic. They are best known for their extraordinary efforts in the World War II and for challenging the stereotypes that had kept black Americans from serving as pilots in the United States Armed Forces. The 99th Pursuit Squadron and the 332nd Fighter Group were the first black flying group to deploy to Italy in early 1944, the Tuskegee Airmen.
The Bernie Hayes program is produced at NLEC-TV right here at 2428 Woodson Road in Overland, Missouri. It's our new headquarters since they closed the 1411 Locust building. We're working to get back into that building. In addition to that, trying to help so many people through a wide variety of safe houses, training programs, transportation assistance, so many ways people are getting help because of all of you that are supporting the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. Now, if you'll send a gift of $25 or more, we want to send you this special, the Bernie Hayes Show Cup. And we're giving that to people as just a way of saying thank you. So when you send your gift, request a cup. We'll be happy to get it off to you. It's New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. You can give online at nlecstl.org. Now I'm really asking all of you to join us in praying. The needs are so phenomenal at this particular time. So many hurting and homeless people are contacting us daily, but we're able to help them because of each one of you that are praying, caring, and sharing at this time.
And welcome back. My guest is the president of the St. Louis School Board, Dr. Joyce Roberts. Dr. Roberts, Bob Demler, our producer and director, had a question. When teachers return to the classroom, are they must be vaccinated?
Bernie, the district has offered a number of opportunities, and we're working very closely with the health department, mm-hmm. and we've offered vaccination clinics across the metropolitan area. Our teachers have been vaccinated. As you know, parents have the opportunity of vaccinating their young people beginning at the age of 12. And it's a personal decision, but we all are encouraging everyone to be mindful that the best way to ensure that everyone stays healthy is to make the best decision for the entire community. And I can't say that enough, because our goal is to return to in-person school in August, and we want everyone to be safe. The district has put in place all of the safety precautions that have been outlined. We've shared that with the community. We'll continue to share that information. It's on the website for anyone who wants to go back and take a look at it. And the website is www.slps.org. Mm-hmm. I've been fully vaccinated, and I encourage everyone to keep us all safe. Even here, Bernie, we're in separate rooms, so we're socially distanced here. So COVID is very serious. There's been an uptick with the variants that is in Missouri. I think we're probably number two on the number of cases. And so I'm encouraging everyone to stay safe and to keep everyone else safe. Mm.
The students, are they required to wear masks?
Yes, everyone is required to wear masks. I double mask. Each time I go to the main building, my temperature is scanned, and I do keep my mask on. And I'll continue to do that until I'm comfortable enough to do something different. You may see me outside, and I'll still have my mask on. Mm-hmm.
Anything that you want to talk about that I haven't asked you about, Dr. Roberts?
Certainly. Mm-hmm. I mentioned earlier about the moratorium. I'm asking every parent to stand with us on that. Your voice does matter, and so it would help us to come up with a plan that includes all of our stakeholders' input. And I say that because charter schools just pop up. We don't know that they're coming until they're in place. And so we want to ensure quality education for all kids, no matter where they are. And I believe a solid citywide plan would be the place to start. And mm-hmm. Dr. Adams is leading that effort. I do want to also share that there is a concern among the board around TIFs. And we've been in conversation with our aldermen about that. And we will continue to lead into that effort, because we feel our kids need to be our top priority. And TIFs allow a deferment of payment to the school district over time. It may be 10 years before we realize any revenues. And it may even go up to 23 years at the end of that TIF. I think there is a way that everyone can win, and that our kids should always be that priority.
And Dr. Roberts, you do work with the state legislature. They do visit you, and they keep a tab on what's going on with the St. Louis Public Schools.
Yes, thank you for that question. I am in contact with our state legislators and our senators and representatives. I do visit Jeff City to support them in their work, and also to encourage them to support the district. And so I also go to the ward meetings and take advantage of any opportunity I can to interact with them, to include the aldermanic meetings mm-hmm. that are now being Zoomed. Before COVID, I went to those every Friday too. One of my roles is advocacy, and I do that every opportunity I get.
And I know that the new elected mayor, Tashar Jones, is also a very grand supporter of you. And I just want to say thanks again, Dr. Roberts, for visiting with us here at the New Life Evangelism Center. Please keep on doing what you're doing.
Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you. And we're at 2428 Woodson Road in Overland, Missouri. Our zip code is 63114. That's 2428 Woodson Road, Overland, Missouri, 63114. We ask for your continued support of Reverend Larry Rice and the New Life Evangelistic Center and the whole staff here. I'm Bernie Hayes. So until next time, I ask you, please, stay safe.